Business model was actually invented by Mr. Alexander. I cannot pronounce his complete name, but it gives you a framework to clearly identify where your business can make money and where your main focus should be. Okay, so basically, in the business model, we have three aspects of value. So we because all the businesses we are creating value. Value towards your own business and value towards your consumers. Value towards the economy or value towards the government or wherever. There are many stakeholders, right, in the business. So all the stakeholders need some kind of value from that particular business. So businesses are creating values, businesses are delivering the values and also capturing the values. Okay, so the business model has 9 segments. So we divide them into 3 main segments. One is how we create it, how we create a value, how do we deliver the value, and how do we capture it back? Because it's not only take, it's only give, it's take also, right? So creating the value means we are first understanding what is the value that we are going to create. So what is our value proposition, right? Then you have key activities, what are we going to do? So what is the meaning of key activity? Does everything counts as a key activity or is something very specific? What is the definition of key activity? If you think of any activity, any company, let's say for example Grab, what are their key activity? What are they doing? What are they care the most? What do they care the most? What is the key activity of Apple? So the Grab is focusing on customer acquisition only, right? Do they drive the car by themselves? They don't. And their key activity is maybe to maintain the platform on which their business is running, right? But other sales and marketing, drivers, collecting the payments is not, it's important for the business, but that's not the key focus, correct? What is the key activity for Apple? Is it design, manufacturing, apps? What is their focus on? Huh? No, Apple doesn't care about marketing. Not only the soft, not the software itself. Security also not. They care about customer experience. They care about their design, the design of the phone features. They care about the features, what they are giving. So basically what they are doing is the what kind of customer experience they are giving to their customers, right? So designing is important for them. Designing is extremely important for them because design defines the customer experience, correct? But marketing of the phone is not their key focus. Manufacturing of the phone is not their key focus because they don't manufacture the phone. They just assemble it, correct? So the companies need to identify actually what are their focus, what they want to be good at. For example, Microsoft, what are they good at? They just want to maintain the software they are building, Windows, that's it. There is no other focus they want to focus on. So the key activities means the companies where they need to focus on as a key resource, as a day-to-day, not day-to-day business, as their main focus. The rest of the activities are ancillary. They are important for the business. It doesn't mean they are not important. You still need to focus on them, but that is not the area of focus. So businesses nowadays need to identify what are their focus. So what they do with the other activities, they don't do it or they don't focus on it. They still focus on it. Either they try to find outsource partners for doing these activities or they outsource them. Because that's not their key expertise, right? So businesses need to identify what are their key activities, what they actually want to do. Then key resources. What is the key resource?
Key resources.
Anything what you need to create the value and to deliver the value and to capture it back, correct? For example, any business nowadays, they need a website. If let's say it's an app, for example, Grab, in our previous example, what is the key resource of Grab? No. Resource means what you control. Platform. App is their resource. This is how they get the money, right? Now they launch GrabPay, so their payment gateway is also their resource, correct? So the key resource means what you control, basically, and what you want to control. If the drivers, and that drivers actually fall under key partnerships, because partners means those who share the risk and reward with you. So a business need a partner. For Grab, drivers are their partner. Because if there is no business, will they pay drivers? Nothing, right? They are not paying anything, any fixed fee to the drivers. So drivers are not their resource. Drivers are their partners. If there is a business, the drivers earns it. If there is no business, drivers doesn't earn it. They are just doing a revenue sharing model. And also the risk is shared. So drivers fall in their partnership. So companies are normally very particular on choosing, do they want to do a partnership with somebody or do they want to make a resource? Resource, you need to pay price. Fixed price, maybe a revenue share, but you take all the risk by yourself. Partner is not taking any risk. So when you hire a CEO, CFO, or all the executive team, they are not sharing the risk of business, right? Tomorrow your business doesn't turn profit. Can you say, oh, CFO, please don't take salary because there is no profit? No, right? So in a way, they are your resource. The resources don't share the risk in the business. They share only the reward. And that's why their share is very little. Okay, so key resources, we are also it means that the business need to identify what they need actually to deliver the values, to create the values. So they need maybe marketing. You need a marketing team for that. You need a business app development team, right? You need security guys. Maybe you need partnerships. You need office, you need application, you need website. Whatever you need to create the value in the ecosystem, that becomes your resources. Then the key partnerships. So whatever you don't want to have a resource, means you don't want to bear the cost, you can do as a partnership. Okay, so partners are who share your risk and reward at the same time. So partnerships are very important. And then how much does it cost? The cost model. So value creation means it's a whole cycle. First, we understand the value, what value proposition we are going to do, what are the key activities that we are going to create, how we are going to create it, then what is required to create it, then what are the key partnerships, and what will be the cost of it. Then comes to delivery. So how we are going to delivery. So basically, we need to identify first who is our customer. What are their pain points? How we are going to acquire them? How we are going to retain them? How we are going to upsell them? So that comes under customer relationships. And then finally, the delivery channel. How we are going to deliver it? Are we going to deliver on store, physical? Are we going to deliver online? Are we going to deliver by third parties? We will have our own stores or we have third party stores. Right. So, for example, the difference, Apple has their own stores, correct? Samsung, they have own stores plus they distribute via other channels as well. Apple do the partnership with the telephone companies, right, to sell the phone together as a package. So they don't need to do marketing for the telecom company. Telecom company is doing it. And they are also sharing the risk and rewards of being able to sell it or not able to sell it, correct? So you can have multiple delivery channels, actually. You may want to sell on your own stores, you may sell on the third party store, you may sell on Amazon, you may sell on your own website, or you may do the affiliate marketing, correct? So you can have multiple delivery channels, how you are going to deliver your products, the promise that you are making to the customer. Okay, so we, yes.
Technologies.
Yes. So you can have multiple values.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Depends on,
let's finish this one and then I will show you a business model of two companies. Then we will be able to understand more. Then we have how we capture the value. So again, how we are going to collect the money and what are the cost models. So where does it start basically?